Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. Today you're joining me in the flight deck of the Airbus A320 on the ground in Tenerife, where it's currently a very warm 37 degrees here on the ground. And I wanted to make a quick video just to talk through some of the considerations we need to make as pilots when operating in high temperatures. So flying the A320 in hot weather does present some unique challenges. So there are some A320 specific considerations, but of course there are considerations that affect all aircraft. So in hot weather conditions, air density decreases, impacting aircraft performance. This affects our takeoff thrust, our climb performance, and even our cooling systems. So we can expect higher takeoff speeds due to the lower air density, requiring higher speeds for liftoff and longer takeoff rolls. So we currently have the APU1 doing its best to keep the aircraft cool. So we do want to look at our condition page here, see how it's doing. Temperature is slowly coming down, but in these extremes of heat, the APU can struggle, and it's important to recognise that. Something we can do is connect external air as well to help take the pressure off the APU. So that is a consideration. But we do want to ensure correct cabin ventilation. We also want to come over to the fuel page and check our fuel temperatures. So they're currently nice and low. But on hot days like this, the fuel in the tanks does get heated by the sun shining onto the wings. So it's important to be wary of that. We do have a maximum fuel temperature of 54 degrees in the A320. You can see now it is actually increasing in temperature. So we have gone up a degree since we've been talking. We need to keep an eye on that. Something else we also want to check in hot weather is our brake temperatures. We could be on a turnaround here. The aircraft could have recently landed. The very hot conditions make it difficult for the brakes to cool. So we want to check out the brake temperatures. So the aircraft's been standing still for a while, so they're pretty much at the air temperature outside, 35 degrees. So that's not an issue, but that's definitely one we want to keep an eye on. And we certainly want to be more mindful during a taxi of using heavy braking, as we could overheat the brakes more easily in these conditions. Now, something we could do here is, obviously we've got the pack flow selector. We could turn this to high to get more airflow through the cabin. Hopefully if the aircraft had been sitting on stand here for some time, what we really want to see is the shades closed here to help keep the cockpit cool. And that's something we would do if we were parking here now for the next cruise, just courteous, especially in locations such as Tenerife where we are today. We'd normally have the blinds drawn so the surfaces of the cockpit aren't getting too hot and uncomfortable for the next crew that may be taking over. We do want to make sure that we get in the cabin nice and cool before the passengers come on board. You know, it's nothing worse than coming out of the 37 degree heat of the sun outside into a hot, sticky cabin that is not air conditioned. So we do our best always to ensure that the cabin is at a temperature that is comfortable. Those of you that are particularly observant may have noticed that we have flap config 1+F. Now, I did mention in an earlier video that we do not retract our flaps generally if the temperature is above 30 degrees Celsius. Certainly that's the case with my operator. It does come down to a particular operator's standard operating procedures, so it does vary. But I'll explain the reason for that, and to do that I'm going to jump outside. So here we are outside, sunglasses on in the 37 degree heat. And here's our wing, very nicely modelled. So you'll see we have flaps 1 here, so config 1+F, so with the flaps out at the back of the wing, and at the front you'll see we've got the slats. So the main reason we keep flaps 1+F out is because the aircraft is fitted with a bleed air monitoring system in the leading edge of the wing. So we have an anti-icing system for the wing which bleeds off very warm air from the engines, we're talking many hundreds of degrees, and uses that air to heat the front part of the wing here, sort of behind the slat, to prevent ice buildup. Now that air bleed system has leak detection on it, so if that leak detection system detects high temperatures in certain areas, the system will presume it has a leak. So there are sensors located for that in the front part of the wing here, behind the slat. So essentially what we're doing with the slat is almost providing a bit of a sun visor for those sensors. So it's almost putting a sun cap onto the wing and covering those sensors and providing a bit of extra shade, so we don't get spurious warning messages from the bleed air monitoring system. This is a configuration that is used on a turnaround, so we wouldn't park the aircraft overnight, for example, and I'll touch on the reasons why that is when we jump back into the cockpit. So some other considerations in this configuration are refueling. So you can see when we have flaps one out, it's quite a big section of flap that's come out. It does allow a bit of extra airflow around the wing. We haven't got the flaps transferring heat to the wing, where obviously here we have the fuel tanks. This configuration can cause difficulty with fuel trucks getting under the wing. And let's come back here, you can see there is quite a big impact in terms of space under the wing when having flaps in the 1+F configuration. That's something that we definitely need to be wary of. It may not be possible to have the flaps in config 1+F for refueling. This is where they need to get to plug their inlet hose in. It is, however, a really good position for conducting an inspection of the aircraft, so if you're looking for any form of damage with the aircraft, you can get a really clear view of parts of the aircraft that you parts of the wing you wouldn't normally be able to see in this configuration. Right, before we get sunburnt, I'm going to jump back inside the cockpit. Now I mentioned that this is a turnaround state, having flaps config 1+F, and we wouldn't leave the aircraft parked in this position. And the reason for that is that the rudder travel limiter is linked to the flap position. So what we can't do is leave our flaps in config 1+F and basically shut the aircraft down and turning our ideas off particularly. And that's because if we have a strong gust of wind, that's going to blow the rudder around, and the rudder limiter, which is designed to limit the range of rudder movement at high speed, can get damaged. So whenever we're parking for a longer period and having to shut down the aircraft and depower the aircraft, we would take the flaps to zero. Now let's say our fuel truck turned up, couldn't get under the wing, and we needed to bring the flaps in. Obviously we don't have engine power at the moment. Now the yellow electric hydraulic pump is capable of doing that task and bringing the flaps in. So here on the overhead we've got our electric pump. We will turn that on, but in order to take the pressure off that system, we also come right back here at the back of the panel and we turn on our blue hydraulic pump override here, which is also an electrically operated system, has an electric motor. So we come down to our hydraulic page now. You'll see that we've got the blue system running and we have the yellow system, which is also pressurizing the system and transferring hydraulic pressure from the yellow system over to the green system. This is the optimum position for bringing our flaps in, so we can bring those up now. And they quickly retract as normal. And once that's done, we can turn that system back off. And also turn our electric hydraulic pump off as well on the yellow system. If we do get that warning message occur, so the air bleed monitoring system does detect a leak, this is what you'll get. It does take some time to rectify that and diagnose to ensure that isn't an actual leak. It does cause quite a timely delay if we do get that message come up. which is why we normally opt, and certainly my operator opts, to leave flaps at config 1 plus F. But just coming back in to check our temperatures. So our fuel temperature, you'll see, has increased to 20 degrees now, so it is picking up in temperature. The outer tank's 21 now, so it's certainly starting to heat up. Checking the cabin, so we're holding 24 degrees. We're pumping 13 degrees in there at the back. It is hard to maintain a lower temperature, especially when we've got the doors of the aircraft open and there's hot, humid air flowing in. The system is really fighting against that. We do have to remember we are effectively sitting in a tin can in the heat, so it's not the easiest thing to keep cool. So I hope that gives you an understanding of why we use config 1 plus F on the turnaround during hot conditions when it's above 30 degrees Celsius. Also, there's a few other considerations there. I hope you found that sort of real-world perspective useful. Feel free to use the comments section if you have any questions. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.